The membership options page is where an unregistered customer is sent when they try to view protected content. This is where they're sent to purchase a membership. And this is the page where you display the benefits and options for memberships. The design we'll use is a table with membership levels, benefits, and PayPal buttons at the bottom. You can use any design you want to fit your site needs. For this course, we'll be using the Websimon Table plugin. This is an easy-to-use plugin and has nice layouts and features. Navigate to the plugin's admin panel and click Add New. Enter Websimon in the search box and click the search button. Locate the Websimon Table plugin and click Install Now and OK, and then Activate on the Success screen. This plugin installs under the Tools admin panel. Navigate to Tools and click on Websimon Tables. To start, enter a name in the name field. This is used as a reference and is not part of the table design. At this point, it would help to know how many levels of membership you want and the benefits for each level. You can have a single column or a multi-column layout. For the course, we have a free basic site build, a membership site build, and an e-commerce site build. We can start with four columns. One column to list the benefits, and one column for each membership type. And we can start with five rows. We can add rows as needed. Give the table a name and enter five rows and four columns, and click the Add Table button. The new table will be listed in the All Tables table. Locate the table and click the Edit Table Content link. It's on this screen where we design and maintain the Membership Options page table. Plain text or graphics can be used in the design. The table for this membership site will have plain text for the headers and for the benefits, with PayPal buttons for payments. The first column is for the list of benefits. You can leave this header blank or enter benefits in the header field. Now, in the header field of each of the other columns, enter the membership level name. Now, enter the benefits. One benefit in each of the fields under the benefits column. And a word of warning, before you add a column or a row, click the Save Tables button to preserve any information you entered. Click the Save Tables Content button when complete. Now, for each benefit, enter a yes or a no to indicate if the benefit is available for that membership level. When complete, click the Save Table Content button. Now we need a row for pricing and the PayPal buttons. For the row before the Payments button, we'll enter the price of each level. Add a new row by clicking the arrow at the bottom of the last row. Now enter the pricing description under each of the levels and click the Save Table Content button. Add a new row by clicking the arrow at the bottom of the last row. Since there's no payment for the free membership level, we'll not have a PayPal button. To direct the user to the registration screen, we can use an HTML anchor with an image. The registration link can be found under General Options on the Login/Registration Design screen. Copy this URL and add it to an image and an HTML anchor. Paste the complete HTML in the field. Click the Save Tables button. At this point, the table may not have the look that fits your site. But when you edit the table structure and style, you can get it to look very nice. Now we can add the table to the Membership Options page, even though we don't have the PayPal buttons created. Since we're using a short code, we can continue to make changes to the table, and they'll be immediately reflected in the table on the page. As long as we use the same table, we'll not need to edit the Membership Options page again. Copy the table short code, and then navigate to the Membership Options page, and paste the short code and click the Update button. Also, you may want to uncheck the discussion settings since there's not a need for comments on this page. Uncheck the buttons and click Update. Click Preview to see how the table looks with your theme. Themes will have an impact on how the table looks. You can make adjustments to the table by clicking the Edit Tables and Style link for that table. And now we need to add the PayPal buttons for each level, which will be in the PayPal button creation video.